Hello, welcome to the lecture on marginal costing. I am Dr. Devali, Assistant Professor, Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. Today I am going to discuss unit number 2, marginal costing. This topic concerned with MCOM Part 2, Semester 4, Compulsory Paper 2, Management Accounting. Outline of this lecture, learning objective of marginal costing, introduction of marginal costing, meaning of marginal costing, application of marginal costing, basic concept of marginal costing, and finally we want to conclude this discussion. Learning objective of this concept, after learn marginal costing, we may able to understand basic concept of marginal cost and marginal costing. Second objective is there to understand the difference between the absorption costing and marginal costing. Then to learn practical application of marginal costing and understand break-even chart and their limitation. First of all, we want to introduce concept of marginal costing. Marginal costing and absorption costing, that is we can say traditional costing or technique of costing. Marginal costing is defined as the change in aggregate cost due to change in volume of production by one unit. The marginal cost of product is its variable cost. It is technique used for decision making by the management. It is used for the interpretation of cost to measure the profitability. Marginal costing means any expenses increase or decrease according to volume is known as marginal cost. Its total cost classified into fixed cost, variable cost and semi-variable cost. Fixed cost, for example, managerial expenses, rent, tax, etc. Variable cost, raw material, power, commission, etc. And semi-variable cost may be partly and fixed and partly variable. Then how we consider marginal cost? In marginal cost we consider direct material, direct labor, direct expenses, variable part of overhead, and finally we may calculate marginal cost for per unit. For the understanding of this concept, we refer definition, first one according to CIMA London. Marginal cost means the ascertainment of marginal cost and the effect on profit of change in volume or types of output by differentiating between fixed and variable cost. Marginal costing has defined, another definition is there. Ascertainment of cost and measuring the impact on profit of change in the volume of output or types of output. Considering definition of marginal costing, we may point out features of marginal costing. It is differentiated between fixed cost and variable cost. It is a technique of cost recording and reporting. Fixed costs do not find place in the product cost. It is a very useful technique of costing for decision making. It determines relatively profitability. Advantages of marginal costing. It is useful in taking decision on pricing policy. It is used for preparation of break-even point. It helps to management in taking business decision like as start or discontinue of particular product or project. Basic concept is marginal costing, marginal cost, marginal costing, absorption costing, direct costing, differential costing, marginal contribution, break-even point, break-even chart, profit volume ratio. Here we consider contribution. This is difference between selling price and variable cost of production. Another concept is there, break-even point. This is level of activity, there is neither profit nor loss Another concept is their profit volume ratio. It is ratio establishing the relation between contribution and sales value. Then margin safety is important concept is there. This is difference between the expected level of sales and break-even sales. It's we may calculate margin safety is equal to sales minus VP sale. For the marginal costing, there have some several formulas, many formulas. Here we will consider contribution. Contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost. Profit. Profit is equal to contribution minus fixed cost. Break-even point, VP is equal to fixed cost divided contribution per unit. Then profit-volume ratio. Profit-volume ratio is equal to contribution divided sales multiply 100. In this way, we may calculate marginal costing. Statement of marginal costing. First of all, we may consider sales less variable cost. Variable cost include direct material, direct labor, factory overhead, selling expenses, distribution overhead, and we get contribution. And from the contribution, we may deduct or less fixed cost, including factory overhead, administrative overhead, selling and distribution overhead, and finally we get profit, absorption costing, and marginal cost. Next part is there, what is different between marginal costing and absorption costing? Absorption costing, it is costing system which treated all manufacturing cost including both fixed and variable cost as product cost. And marginal costing, it is costing system which treated only the variable manufacturing cost as product cost. The fixed manufacturing overhead are regarded as period cost. Finally, we want to conclude this concept. In this concept, we may learn concept of marginal costing, meaning of marginal costing. For this purpose, we refer some definition. Application of marginal costing, basic concept of marginal costing. Marginal, finally, it is said that marginal costing helps to take managerial decision if we start in a product or start in a project, that time we want to recover our investment, and that decision depend on marginal costing whether our project start or stop. You may refer some book for the detailed understanding. Khan and Jain for management accounting. I am Pandey, management accounting. These are some reference book. If you have any doubt, query, please contact me. Myself, Dr. Devali PM, Assistant Professor, Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. Mobile number is there, 9049-0891-1926. My email ID, paresh84jam@readypmail.com. Thank you.